Even as we shelter in place, time flies. It is hard to believe that we have reached the end of our Lenten journey. Golgotha and the empty tomb are in sight. Little did we know at the start of Great Lent, as we celebrated the Sunday of Orthodoxy with the procession of the holy icons, that the new Israel, like the chosen children of Israel of old, would have to journey through the wilderness of self-isolation. As we stop and reflect here at the threshold of Holy Week, I pray that all of us, to some degree, were liberated from the yoke of sinful passions through our ascesis of prayer and fasting. Having been denied the bread of life from the life-giving chalice, I pray our good Lord fed each one of us with manna from heaven, satisfying our individual hunger and providing for our spiritual needs directly from heaven. Standing at the crossroads between Great Lent and Holy Week brings us closer to the promised land. It appears that this coronavirus cross, which we all bear on our shoulders to varying degrees, will deprive us of our most solemn and sacred liturgical services. We will have to dig deep into our hearts to discover the faith necessary to relive noetically the divine drama, starting with the Saturday of Lazarus, into Palm Sunday, Judas's betrayal, the crucifixion, and our Lord's glorious resurrection. By faith, we can receive the holy light, even as we practice social distancing from our churches, out of our love and concern for our brothers and sisters. Saint Iakovos Tsalikis, while he kept guard during the Greek Civil War, exhibited great charity and relinquished his pass to a fellow soldier, thus denying his own Holy Week participation. In his own words, Saint Iakovos explained, "I was serving guard duty, and I was on a hill watching the citizens of Athens going to their churches, and I was trying to repeat the prayer of Jesus. And on the night of Pascha, when I heard the joyous bells, I sighed and I said, 'Oh my Christ, now our Christians are receiving your holy light.' And as I said this, the holy light came to me as well. A light came from on high and rested on me, and I became all light." This man of God had sacrificed the created light of the Paschal candle, and in return received the uncreated light of divinity. Behold the fruits of love for neighbor. I leave you with this verse from Romans 8:38-39. "For I have been persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things coming, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing like the coronavirus shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord." Καλή δύναμη, καλή μεγάλη εβδομάδα, καλή Ανάσταση.